Hey, nothing to see here.
Hey guys, today we're going to be taking a look at the McFarlane Toys DC Multiverse Atom Smasher figure from the new Black Adam movie, as well as the Atom Smasher Mega Fig. I can't wait to take a look at these figures, so let's get into their packaging. Alright, so I'm not even going to bother with reviewing this packaging because it's basically the exact same as this guy. So taking a look at Atom Smasher's packaging, as you can see, we have a front viewing window. Up on top, it tells us it's from the Black Adam wave. Of course, it's from McFarlane Toys. On the bottom here, we got Black Adam and Atom Smasher. On the side, Atom Smasher. On the other side, Atom Smasher from the Black Adam movie. And on the back, we have this really awesome artwork right here. We have the same thing in the Hawkman figure, and this just looks super cool. And then, of course, on the bottom, you got the barcode right there. So let's go ahead and crack open these figures' packaging. Right, so just for some quick first thoughts on the figures, obviously, these guys look pretty much exactly the same suit-wise, but there is, of course, a massive size difference. I will say, though, in hand, it feels like this guy's a little bit more stiff, but actually, the bigger figure feels more free in movement. But we'll get more into that with the articulation segment. But I do love this suit design. It looks pretty cool. Maybe the colors could be swapped, like instead of this light blue being for the mask, it could be dark blue and then the rest of it is blue. I don't know how it would look though. I think the figure looks pretty good right now and it looks like he's got a pretty good amount of detail. So taking a look at the accessories for these figures, both of them come with the DC Multiverse stand. You know how this thing works? You can stick your figures on it, but it is kind of funny how comically small this one is compared to like the Mega Fig Atom Smasher. I don't know how the heck you would be able to use that really well. It would just look very weird. And then they also come with the exact same trading card right here. Atom Smasher from the Black Adam movie, and of course it's that same image that we had on the back. And then you can pause to read the bios right there. And then finally, the Atom Smasher smaller figure does come with two additional hands. So these are fists instead of these more open, like grabbing hands. All right, so taking a look at the sculpting and detail for the Atom Smasher smaller figure. I think the head sculpt on this guy actually looks pretty good, and it looks like an Atom Smasher. I like how the insignia here is sculpted in, and the rest of the suit is actually sculpted, which is pretty awesome. Like you can see right here on the mask, that looks really nice. Belt is kind of plain, but it's got some detail there. I like the metal down here. It looks pretty sweet. And then, yeah, I think this is a pretty well-sculpted figure, and there's a lot of detail on this guy. I think it looks pretty awesome. Now, for the bigger Atom Smasher figure, it's basically exactly the same. I really like this guy. He's got a lot of the same sculpting details, especially on the suit. And then, for the legs, he's got basically the exact same figure. I mean, it's literally this figure, but bigger. And honestly, it kind of leaves up for more detail in the head sculpt. I kind of like this guy's head sculpt better than the smaller Atom Smasher. And I know it's like barely different, but I feel like because it's bigger, it allows for more distance between the eyes. Something like that looks cooler to me. So for Atom Smasher's articulation, you can move the head around here. It is very stiff though, at least mine is, but you can get some good rotation. Arms go out and around, out and in. You got some bicep swivel right here, double jointed elbows. These hands go out and in, and so does this hand. The torso right here, you can move all the way around. You can swivel side to side and crunch a little bit. Legs go out and not really that much to the side. They can kick back. He's got some double jointed knees. Ankle articulation, you can move it around up and down. And then he's got some toe articulation. For the articulation for the Atom Smasher Mega Fig, he can look all the way around. He's got a lot of good movement here. The arms go out and in. He's got a butterfly joint, unlike the other Atom Smasher. Well, actually, I think he does. It's just very hard to see. But this one is a little bit more noticeable. Bicep swivel right there. Double jointed elbows. Hands go out and in. So does this hand. It's got some pretty good torso movement. You can swivel side to side, up and down. Legs kick out and back. And then you got some double jointed knees that are really good there. And then the articulation on the ankle and some toe articulation right there. All right, so let's take a look at some size comparisons. Starting off with Dr. Fate, who is also a part of the Black Adam movie. And here you can see him up next to the Atom Smasher figures. Here they are up next to Hawkman, who is also from the Black Adam movie wave. And finally, here they are up next to Swamp Thing, who may be the only figure taller than this Atom Smasher. So overall, I think Tom McFarlane actually did a pretty good job on these Atom Smasher figures. They have some pretty lackluster accessories. They don't really come with much, but the detail on them is really good, and it seems like they have some pretty good articulation. Not the best you can get out of McFarlane figures, but they do compare really well in size together and with other figures. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like. And of course, if you haven't already and you want to see more of this, subscribe. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye.